Get out of my room, Travis!
Stories, stories. Always with the stories.
Get out!
I read the Fangs one. I liked, the Beast. At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
No trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow. I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves, and we blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name a thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
Thank you. Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
No, huh? What the hell's wrong with you exactly?
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. They're freaking everyone out.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing! I found a room, I walked in...
You can feel it, right? Something, something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it. Ethan disturbed the sleeper. He must be punished. You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Really? Okay, I will go talk to him. Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy. You've all gone crazy.
Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on.
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind.